Hey folks, Nick Norton from the Angels. I am the vocalist of the last year onwards and upwards with the band. We have a brand new single out called 99. It's the title track of the upcoming album 99, which is coming out on June 28th, the end of this month. We're very excited about the album and the single, and we're about to go on tour in that same weekend, last weekend of June. We're hitting the entire country, so 50 years, 50 years not out is the name of the tour, because the Angels have been around for 50 years. Of course they have. Of course we have. It's crazy days. So we can't wait to see you on the road.
Beautiful, Nick. Thanks for joining us today.
No worries. Thanks, Kris. Thanks for having me.
No worries. Before we get going, though, mate, like by the looks of you, you wouldn't have even been born when they started 50 years ago.
Yeah, I mean, that's correct. Yes, I think the band started in 74. I was there for the 40th. Anniversary, but yeah, I came to the band about, well, the same time as Dave Gleeson, as Gleeso, in about 2011 on drums, and with Dave singing. But yeah, I sort of grew up like a lot of people in Australia with kind of on the tail end of that first classic era of the Angels, and then I guess I was a younger kid when all that that sort of second round stuff was happening with Beyond Salvation and both the and Howling and those albums. And then sort of met John around the time I finished high school and started doing stuff with him, and he was kind of working with my original band straight out of high school as a kind of mentor, and then or as a sort of a producer, a mentor type guy. And then I started doing the Brewster Brothers thing with Rick and John much later on again, as a sort of side man in that band. And then 2011 they called me up and said, we've offered the tour to Buzz, but we think he's going to say no. So are you interested in playing drums in the Angels? To which I responded with, what? So yeah, I very quickly strapped my rock boots on, and yeah, the rest is history. We've just been going hard ever since, but yeah, it's brilliant. Like I've known John forever and done, you know, heaps of stuff with him, songwriting and Rick the same length of time. And now we're all writing. We've just written a full album of songs together. Yeah,
fantastic, mate. So, as you say in the intro, the Angels have announced your 14th studio album, 99, for release on June 28th. So, how are you feeling about it, mate? Like, you confident?
Yeah, well, I mean, we're stoked about the album. I actually haven't been this excited about a new album since I was. I mean, in at least 10 plus years. I mean, it's always good to be on recordings, and it's an exciting thing, but it's just, this one, I've repeatedly said it to the band. I think I keep surprising the guys how kind of excited I am about it, because it's like I'm just really satisfied with the way the tracks have gone down, the way we've sort of really made sure that everything has just been done to a T exactly as we wanted. And even from a vocal perspective, it's the most time I've ever taken to really nail parts and lay it up all these interesting harmonies and kind of got it exactly as I was hearing it. And you know, we've taken time with some of these tracks. We recorded the rhythm section stuff 4 years ago, and we've then layered some guitars up since. And then kind of since not long before Christmas last year, we went on this whole extra kind of thing to get the album finished. And we did a couple of big sessions down in Melbourne at Light Hill Studios with Ricky Ray to kind of get the album all finished up for the 50th year. And suddenly it's just gone from being this kind of, oh yeah, we'll get around to finishing the album, to just like, this is, we actually have something here, let's do this. So yeah, we're super stoked about it. Yeah.
And as you say, you've released the title track 99 as the first single, so why choose that one to open the album, to announce the album, I guess?
Yeah, well, I think I wrote that one with Sam, actually. Like, he wrote the riff quite a while back. We demoed that, put that down a few years ago, and then I kind of wrote a lyric and melody for it a while back. And as soon as that was completed, I think everyone just went, oh, that's got to be the single. This was, you know, probably 4, 5, 6 months ago. They're like, that'll be the single, obviously. And I was like, oh, will it? Okay, great. Because it's just got that kind of punk rock energy. It's like faster tempo. It's got that Angels. Well, John and Rick call that, you know, dun, 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 the Nick-Nicks. It's got a little bit of the Nick-Nick action, which a few of the tracks on this album have, and that'll never go all together from the Angels sound. And yeah, I think it just has that, it's high energy, it's kind of punk rock, and, you know, it reminds people the Angels are still a rock band, a hard rock band with a kind of an aggressive thing, which is, I don't know, like for Sam and me as younger dudes in the band, that's important because we don't, you know, some rock bands, maybe heritage rock acts, get a little bit, it gets all a little bit songwriter-ish and it gets a little bit relaxed, whereas it's still a riff-driven band and still a hard rock band, you know, and we want to kind of remind people of that.
Yeah. So is that a good representation of the album as a whole of what people can expect?
Yeah, well, it's a there's about another three tracks on there that are right up in that vein of that sort of tempo and that heaviness. But then there's a mixed bag on the album, but it is still very rock. I mean, we put out, you know, we've put out a few little things in 2020 during that lockdown year. We put out an EP that was a little bit more sort of laid back, and that flew under the radar a bit. It was less of a public announcement, but this album's a full-blooded rock album. Them that's sort of riff driven and so yeah, that's I think if you like the single, you'll love the album for sure.
Wait. Now, just going back a little bit, bro. Like you've been with the band for about 10 years now, starting as a drummer. So you've been writing with the band the whole time. But what was it? Did it take a while to sort of, because like John and Rick had have their style, you know, they've been doing it for so long. Was it hard for you to come in and did you have to adapt to their style or did they encourage you to bring your own?
Sort of a bit of both. Like, yeah, they're really open to anything, John and Rick. Like, but they're, I mean, yeah, they are. They definitely, after 50 years, do things their way. They've got certain systems, and that definitely applies to kind of the live thing as well. The live shows they're really particular about how they, especially, you know, Rick has ideas about how things should translate live. John's maybe a little bit more kind of open and experimental, but. Rick's really regimented with that stuff, but then when it comes to the creative thing, I think Rick just gets excited by anything that's kind of a new idea that's fresh and exciting. And he, I think they're just anytime they hear brand new music that is good, they're just like, oh, what's that? So when we kind of, I come with a melody or a riff, or Sam comes with a demo that he's put together at home that's kind of riff driven, and there's even stuff on here like, well, we've got. Tom Brewster, who is John's other younger son, Sam, the younger brother, he's now drumming in the band as well. He's manning my old drum stool, and so he's bringing his kind of Angels DNA into the band. And yeah, it's just been with as far as songwriting goes, I think John and Rick are very open to anything, but it's sort of us, Sam and I, that are going, well, here's something in the style of the Angels, you know, because we kind of want it to have that the knick-knick still, you know, so because we love that, so yeah, and we know it works, we know the punters love it, and it's worked for 50 years, so you don't want to change that formula, you know.
Yeah. Now, John has been quoted as saying that there was a lot of spontaneity with this album. If someone had an idea, then we recorded it. Like, can you elaborate on that? Like, does that mean you wrote it in the studio a lot or?
Yeah, there was a bit of that, like where we're just putting ideas down on the fly. There'd be things like Rick could just come with a partial demo or just a riff, and then the four there were four of us there in January that would just be we were like smashing out Rick's arrangements, you know, assembly line style. But then Rick didn't necessarily have full songs completed, so I'd then take his demo away and well, not at that point it wasn't a demo, we had a track, but I would sort of listen to that. And I've got quite a lot of sets of lyrics already written. And then I just kind of fashion a melody from lyrics around that song. But yeah, it doesn't take me long these days to sort of hear an idea and then go, I know, that will work actually. And I, some that can come down to just hearing like if one of Rick's riffs is really strong or just, you know, he the might even be just a more of a chord driven song. But I'd be like, oh, that's kind of cool. It's got this hip thing happening here. I want to work that into a tune. And so yeah, it was like there was yeah, they're not Rick's definitely not precious because I think he realizes he's kind of got these skeletons or you know the bare bones of songs, and then he's like, this is pretty good. Here's an idea. Now let's just get this completed as a band, and everyone just kind of goes, and then it just works, you know. So yeah, it's good. It's got to be that way these days, I think, more and more because I mean. Back in the day, obviously John and Rick were super creative young dudes, and they were writing all this stuff, and they would do the, you know, go thirds with Doc and sort of Brewster, Neeson, Brewster, and they'd have even sometimes if someone had kind of almost written the whole song themselves, they would quite often just split it three ways because it was sort of a collaborative thing. But that always worked because they were these sort of hungry young men that were like writing these amazing songs that became like iconic to like a couple of generations of people. But now they, you know, they're not maybe writing as prolifically as they were back then. So when there's an idea there's just this thing of like, if anyone's got something valuable, bring it to the table, you know? So yeah, it actually works.
Yeah, very good. Now, this is your first album as frontman for the Angels, mate. So did you feel the pressure of 50 years of history going into it?
Well, not really. I think it's kind of like, because you know, I just love the creative side of all of being a musician, and I mean the whole job's creative, obviously. But like it, yeah, I songwriting and kind of coming up with parts, and especially something like lyric and melody writing is sort of more my forte. So I kind of just knew, well, I can do this stuff, and it's what I do. And if I'll just throw ideas at Rick, and he'll just either like it or not, because Rick's, you know, he knows what he wants. So if it's something he wasn't into, he'd be like,
Not backwards,
meh.
coming
But
forwards.
that, yeah. So it was just really like, for me, easy. And I haven't felt any. Maybe when I first got the gig in the band, which is coming up on a year ago, but when I first started touring with the band as singer in September last year, you know, for a couple of weeks there, it was a bit like, this is kind of interesting. I wonder how fans will respond. You know, they've had two pretty iconic front men in the band over the years, and you know, Dave being a real larrikin career front man, Doc being this iconic, internationally renowned front man. So I was like, yeah, but then I never sort of thought about it because I'm like, you know, fuck it, the songs are here, the riffs are here, this band kill, and you know, the fans will hear those songs and just go nuts, which is what they've done anyway, because how many more decades are left, you know, how many more anniversaries are left, so that people just come to shows and go, this is amazing, you know.
Actually, along those lines, bro, like you did step into the front man role, take it over from Dave Gleeson after he left. So fans of the Angels have always been very loyal, so very patriotic sort of people. So how did they accept it? Did you find there were certain elements of the fans that you had to win over more than others?
Yeah, I mean, there's always going to be naysayers, and I think that's, yeah, I mean, the best thing to do is a, you know, is to just kind of, it's easier than said than done, but obviously you just kind of shut all that out or ignore that and just get on with the job of like playing music, because that's, you know, they people do often forget that at the end of the day, John and Rick and the Angels have always just been musicians, and they just need to get on the road because it's their job. So one way or another, they find a way to just get back out on the road and keep playing. So yeah, audiences were have actually been pretty bloody good. And it's that whole thing, it's the live thing, you know, like the naysayers are usually sitting at home on social media, tapping away on the keyboards. So they're not, and I get it, they're pretty protective of their brand, like you say, you know, like I grew up with bands that I love that are not quite the same since lineup changes and stuff. But you know, then the people that come to the gigs get to the gig, and within the first song and a half, they're like, oh shit, okay, this is seriously good. And there might be that one song, you know, we do these big two set shows. There might be one song at the start of the first set where they're like, there's a few blokes sort of doing these ones at the front, trying to work out their it's kind of computing what's going on. And then by the third song, there's the smile and they're looking at their mate, bobbing their head because they hear a tune that they haven't seen live in 6 months, and they just, the hair stand up on the back of their neck. So it's like the hard part's always done, because when you start those songs, people just lose their mind anyway. So it's good. Yeah.
Well, now speaking of playing live, mate, the band has also announced the 50 Not Out tour, which kicks off in St Kilda on June 28th, goes to
Yeah.
Victoria, New South Wales, South Australia, back to New South Wales, WA, Queensland, finishes at the Alexander Head Hills Hotel on August the 3rd. Like quite a few dates there, bro. You set a task for yourself.
It's a solid tour. It's yeah, this is kind of more like the traditional touring that I've done in the band the last sort of 12 or so years. I mean, we had, after I got the singing gig, we had this insane run of about 7 months straight, because we had about four tours run back to back into each other, which was just sort of an unusual timing thing. But it was good for the new lineup because it was like a real kick up the ass, and it was like a, you know, a bit of a shot in the arm, in the sense that it was a vote of confidence from all the promoters and all the bookers to book 7 months worth of gigs in a row with a new lineup. But yeah, this tour, it's about 6-7 weeks, and we'll just hit the whole country and do what we do. And yeah, it's a double. It's a one set show, but we got My Sex in support, who we've toured with in the past as well. And they make a really nice kind of complement to what we do. So it's a different style, but they're still a killer rock band, you know. So yeah, we're looking forward to it.
Well, and what can fans expect from the shows, mate? Is there going to be any special birthday treats, like cakes, dancing girls?
Yeah, 50 years, you know, that's a good question. I think just very good classic Angels rock songs will be the main birthday present. And I don't know, who knows what John and Rick will have in store there. They're the kings of chaos, so they, you know, they might just do something chaotic, or we'll see what happens.
No worries. All right, Nick. Well, thanks for your time, bro. Been a pleasure speaking with you. The album 99 is out June 28th. I've had a listen before this interview, mate, and he's a fucking cracker. He's done really well.
Oh, thanks, Kris. Cheers.
Singles out now. Tour kicks off in St Kilda June 28th. So June is the month of the Angels. Get amongst it, bro.
Beauty. Yes, we'll see you on the road.
No!